Hi, my name is Steve Kinney, and this is a course on learning how to code using Scratch. Scratch is a visual programming language that makes it easy to snap together many of the foundational computer science concepts to create games, interactive stories, art, and music easily. In this course, we'll learn how to implement popular game mechanics and other computer science fundamentals. I hope that you find a lot of value in this course, and I hope that it inspires a number of other projects that you and your kids can build together.
It would be nice if something happened when Dave got the taco. The thing about life is sometimes you get what you want and then you just have to go somewhere else to get something else. And so I'm thinking the mechanic for this game, like the game of Snake, is when Dave gets the taco, we move the taco. Right? Let's do it. So in this case, Dave can't move the taco because Dave's code only affects Dave. There's like exceptions to this, but let's just pretend I'm right. So in this case, we need to put this logic inside the taco. And so we might say, now I'm in the taco. Don't be in Dave. There's nothing for you in Dave. We'll say when the green flag is clicked, we could just say, go to a random position. There are reasons why this might be problematic. We'll talk about how to fix it in a little bit, but let's start with that. Go to a random position, and then forever, right, just see if we are touching Dave. Because if we were touching Dave, he was most likely eating us. And we'll do the simplest thing for now. We will just go to a different random position. If Dave has found us, move. Let's try that out and see how it goes. Cool, as soon as I get the taco moves. And I guess I have the beginnings of a game. It doesn't, like, okay, I was gonna say it doesn't feel great, but like, oddly it does. What are some other mechanics that we see, like, in games? Like, what happens usually when you catch something? Like, what are some ways to, like, make us feel good? Yeah.
You extend
this.
Snake.
If it's a snake, I would extend it, and we will do that towards the end. Right, like, so yeah, to your point, like, something about the game changes, right? Like, maybe the difficulty increases, right? Or maybe there's something that makes the game compelling. What's another option?
Score.
Let's do score. We will actually do all of these options. Fun fact. But let's start with a score. So it'd be nice to get a little dopamine hit and be able to say, like, have some kind of idea of a score that might go up as we get the taco. So we can do that by going to a variable where we keep track of the score, right? And so you can make any variables you want. They give you one for free called my variable. You have two choices here. You can choose to make a new one, or you can right click on it and rename it to score. I don't care. You do whichever one you want. So I can rename this one to score. I'm actually gonna show you also, I'm gonna delete this one. If you make one, you can see that you can make it for all the sprites or for this sprite only, right? So if you want a score that only the taco knows about, I don't know why you would hit the sprite only. But like, if you want the current position of this sprite, if you're doing something with this particular sprite, otherwise the score seems like a global variable, right? So we'll call this score. And things that we need to do, I could spread this global code all over the place. We're gonna let the taco be the scorekeeper, right? Because it's gonna be the one that knows when it's been, when Dave has found it. So say when the game starts, set the score to 0. Right, we're resetting the game. And then, if it's touching Dave, change the score by 1 and move to a random position. Awesome. So now you can see the score is going up. I feel great about life. You can see that score in the upper right-hand corner. The other thing that we have in a lot of games is some idea of what I will very loosely call physics. Right? Like something that makes the game feel like right. So let's go ahead and make a new project. And in our new project, we're going to, let's make a new sprite as well. We're gonna need something that falls from the sky.
Apple,
love it. Apple, big fans of the apples around here. Let's make this a little bit smaller for reasons that you will see in a little bit. And so what we want to make the Apple do is we want to make it fall from the sky. Let's get Arnold out of here for a little bit. Want to make our Apple fall from the sky. And like, you could theoretically do something like this. So when you say when it's clicked, what we just want to do is change forever. Or until it hits the ground, but forever in our case. Because like Scratch won't let anything go like into oblivion, and it'll just kind of stop it when it gets to the bottom. So forever, what we want to do is we want to change y by negative 1. Might be too slow. Let's see. A little bit too slow, right? Let's also have something where it goes back to the beginning every time so I don't have to move it. Because I am lazy. And so we'll say, when the green flag is clicked, go back up to the top. And falling a little bit too slowly. We could have it fall at 10, maybe. Again, it's negative if we want it to fall. And that works, right? But that's not how falling works in real life, right? Generally speaking, on Earth, at least, we have this thing called velocity, right? Which is something starts falling. It's kind of like something starts falling, it speeds up as it goes along, right? That's to say, like, if you were to get in a car and put your foot on the gas pedal, the car starts at zero and gets progressively faster, right? You can throw something up in the air. When it hits the highest point, it will start to come down. But, like, as it falls, it speeds up faster and faster and faster and faster and faster, right? And so we can do something like that as well and kind of create, like, mechanics in our game that feel a little bit more natural. To do that, we will need a variable. And let's change this. Let's call it velocity. Velocity. You can call it speed if you want to. It's up to you. Whatever you want to type.
Set variable.
What's up?
Set variable to what, 10 at the start?
Sure. Let me just check something real quick. I'm going to make it again, only for this sprite, for reasons that I will need later on. Future me is going to want it only for this sprite. Okay, so now you can see this one's only for this sprite because it's apple colon velocity, right? Which means it's for the apple. And so when the game starts, we'll set velocity to zero because it's not falling just yet. And when we change it, we want to change by the velocity. I could set it to 1. You get the point, right? Something, right? Some base amount. Oh, we want negative 1. And it will fall, but we want this concept of it getting faster over time, right? And so now that we can store the current speed and we can change it, what we can do is say, okay, like change it, but then also change the velocity by another negative 1. So it starts out in this case as negative 1, then it's become negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, so on and so forth, right? Could we implement the idea of terminal velocity, which is eventually when you like when things are falling, they fall, they get to a certain max speed, they don't go any faster. We could do that. We might do it. I was like, we won't, but I'm like, eh, maybe we will. So now, as you can see, it feels a little bit more natural where it hits the bottom, but it starts to like speed up as it falls. It looks all right, already a little bit more like normal in this case. And like, if you're like too fast, I could say negative 0.5. Right, it'll still get that same effect, but like at a slower rate. And that number will keep going up, but we don't really care. And so down it goes over and over and over again. But it does speed up along the way. Okay, so right now he goes through walls. Interestingly, can't jump while in the walls because my logic works because he's touching red. Which sets his velocity to 0. And, you know, he can kind of move through a floor. Okay, so what we want to do is when he goes face first into a wall, stop. And the reason we're going to do X before Y is because if you think about it, if like Super Mario or Sonic the Hedgehog or what have you jump into a wall, they're still in the jump. They're just not moving forward, right? They continue falling and then they hit the ground. Like, it's just that one of the things happens before the other. So we need something very similar to this. Now, you can do two things. You can try to duplicate it. You will have to swap out a lot of these blocks. I will say that in the Scratch add-ons, there's an ability to like right-click and change blocks, which is super helpful, but I'm not going to assume that you have that installed. And as you watch me use Power Tools, that maybe you can install in your Chrome, but there is a set of Chrome extensions that makes this a little bit easier. Your choice, if you want to play the game of rebuilding this from scratch, or pun unintended, or if you want to kind of like try to copy and paste and swap stuff out, I'll duplicate it and live with the, because that's probably what you probably tried to do as well. We wanted X to go first, so we'll do that first. All right, so then we want to set last X to the X position. And then we want to change X. There. And then we'll change X by that new velocity X, right? So like go, see if you were allowed to go there at all. If not, change it to, we'll set it to, let's set X to last X. Maybe rebuilding it from scratch is easier. We'll set X to that last X. And we'll change the X velocity back to zero. All right, I think I got it, but now we want to do the, since we want to check for the total number of Y and X's, we'll pop in this combination of the two. Get some stuff out of the way. And I can also hit clean up blocks. Okay. Let's see if that did the trick or if I missed something. Woo! He's a little fast at this point. So we got something off here. Jumping works. Can still go through the wall. All right, let's check it out. So we'll go through the steps. We will try to deal with the ceiling first. I don't think we want to do it all those in the same repeat block. All right, I got a little, little carried away in there. Let's see if that fixes it. No, he's still feisty. All right, let's see what we got. So, set X position to last X position. I'll use a Y in here to really ruin my day. Oh, we need that division, right? Like, we have a division here. I didn't put it up here. So let's go ahead. Because otherwise, we're not doing it by small steps. We're doing it literally just too many times. Boom. Oh, he pushed to the wall. Let's see. He does stop at the wall, but it looks like he can also still push through it. Oh, you know what it is? We're also moving by X. Same problem I had before. At least I'm repeating, as I repeat the process, I'm repeating my mistakes. That feels good.
I know why he can stick to walls. He just bites the wall so hard that he can stick to it.
And he just chews through it? Like, he's got, like, zombie powers? There we go. Oof. Oof. Jump. Oh, look at that. He stops. I mean, he's still got infinite jumping abilities.